And experiment two is actually on kidney function and physiology. Right, so the objective of this experiment, you're supposed to be looking into your lab manual. So the objective of this experiment is to study the structure and functions of the excretory system, which are essential in excreting waste and osmoregulation in humans, to measure the effects in the consumption of various concentration of liquids towards urine output. Right, so there are two objectives in this experiment. And going into the experiment, if I can make you recall, yeah, this experiment requires you to prepare lab report. And as usual, before this, your lab report must consist of title, objective, introduction, method, results, discussion, followed by conclusion and references. Okay, so I have here with me the model of the urinary system. That's a model of urinary system. You will be given a diagram on this, so you will need to label the diagram given to you. So let's look at the model here. This is model of the urinary system, and as you can see, there is a pair of kidney. This is the left kidney, this is the right kidney, and urine passes through the ureter into the urinary bladder, and urine passes out through the urinary bladder through the urethra. And then there are blood vessels that supply blood into the urinary system. So you have here in red, this is aorta. So aorta branches into the renal artery, which goes into the kidney. Alright, then leaving the kidney, you have the renal vein, which converges into the inferior vena cava. Okay, next here is the model of a human kidney. So you can see that this is a cross-section of a human kidney. So you can see that there are two distinct regions. Yeah? So the outer region here is the cortex, and then the inner region, dark in color here, is the medulla. Yeah? And urine will trickle from the collecting duct into the renal pelvis, which passes through the ureter, if you can still remember from the previous diagram, and they are all collected in the urinary bladder. So next is looking at prepared slide of human kidney, and looking at these slides, you should be able to identify and label important structures in the slide, such as the glomerulus, the Bowman's capsule, and what will be obvious is the proximal convoluted tubule, because it actually extends or is a continuity of the Bowman's capsule. Students, using a microscope, let's view the prepared slide of human kidney. We are now observing the slide at 100 times magnification. Notice the regions that are stained darker, like this, this, this. Yeah, so these are a network of capillaries called glomerulus. Surrounding each glomerulus is a space that is unstained. Yeah, these are the Bowman's capsule. So glomerulus contains blood plasma, and ultrafiltration occurs in the glomerulus, and this causes filtrate to come through the Bowman's capsule. Students, observing the slide at 400 magnification, the glomerulus appears much larger now, and the unstained space of Bowman's capsules becomes more obvious. Another structure that is now obvious are the tubules. So you can see many tubules side by side. Yeah, so our kidney has up to 1.5 million nephrons. So this cross-section is somewhat perpendicular to the tubules. So also notice the lumen of the tubules, and surrounding the lumens are cells arranged in single layer. If you can recall from the second chapter during the first semester, these are epithelial cells, yeah, particularly simple cuboidal
epithelial cells, which is mainly for secretion and absorption, and the round structures, which is quite prominent in each of the cells. These are the nucleus, being the largest organelle in eukaryotic cells. They can somewhat be identified.
So in this next section of the experiment, you're supposed to actually be collecting urine, involves collection of urine. So the first urine that you collect is known as the initial urine, and then after consuming this certain concentration of fluid, that urine that you collect is known as the final or the post-intervention urine. Alright, so by right, for each group, there should be 3 volunteers to produce 3 initial urine sample, right? And you're supposed to measure the amount of urine produced, and then you're supposed to consume these fluids. Participant A, 800 mils of water. Participant B, 800 mils of 0.9% sodium chloride. Participant C, 80 mils of water in 80 mils of 9% sodium chloride. And you have the formula on how to prepare the solutions. It is in your lab manual. So now, after consuming the solution, you're supposed to wait for 60 minutes, and then at 60 minutes, you're supposed to produce another sample of urine. So you're supposed to observe the volume produced after taking these solutions and compare it to your initial urine. So participant A has initial and final urine, so does participant B, and so does participant C. So even though you will not be collecting the urine sample, but you should be able to produce hypothetical results based on what you have learned in the lecture, whereby if we consider that the initial urine during that time, that is your water potential of the body at normal. So now, after having taken a really hypotonic solution or a hypotonic solution, you would be able to predict the results. For example, if you have taken a very concentrated solution, then your body is going to experience a low water potential, or water potential of the blood decreases. So with that, you're going to have osmoreceptor cells in the hypothalamus to detect, and then your posterior pituitary will produce ADH, and you know that the effect of ADH is causing the collecting duct and the distal convoluted tubule to become more permeable. So that means there will be more reabsorption of water to conserve. And this will cause the production of small volume and concentrated urine. So this would otherwise be different for a person who has taken a hypotonic solution, where then you would see water potential of blood would increase, and therefore you have the posterior pituitary releasing less amount of ADH, so there will be less of reabsorption taking place, and then you have the production of large volume and dilute urine, or less concentrated urine. So in the result, you can present your data in a form of table showing participant volume of urine sample for participant A, B, and C. So there's initial and then there is final. And then you can also present the data in form of a bar chart. And in discussion, your discussion should be about all this osmoregulation.